Well, joining me is Tim Bates, captain of Old Guildford Mundaring, and also Alex Gray, who's the coach. And boys, probably not the best season, fair to say, but you did manage to avoid relegation. Yeah. And I haven't had a drink yet.
It was another tough year, another interesting year for us. We did play in the relegation series again, as well as last year. Although I thought there was a lot of improvement this year. But it's good to start up in the league, and I think the club's looking good for the future.
All right, good stuff. Alex, how is it having an inspirational leader like this guy in the team? It must be a good boost for the rest of the players.
Oh, yeah, it makes a big difference. Like, you measure people when the chips are down. So it's a tough ask to be a leader anyway, and then to play well and to be a key player and all of those things together. So it makes a huge difference. So I think the fact is, like, the second half of the year, I think almost the last half of the year, the games that were lost by a goal, and we're pretty even. So they were right there, they're close. So, and, you know, Tim and what he's been doing makes a big difference. So, like he says, hopefully the corner is being turned.
All right, good stuff. And how are you going to turn around next year, guys? What's the strategy at this early stage?
Train harder. Big long pre-season, work hard over the spring as well. And I think we've brought in a lot of younger players, the fresh blood, the fresh players, mature. Maybe one or two surprises as well. And the AIS draft will change again. And, like, there's nothing in it. A team such as ourselves or Fremantle as well down the ladder, two players in the side, a good start of the year, and all of a sudden you're third, fourth spot. So it can change quickly.
How about some more imports? Because you did have a very good one this season, didn't you? A Spanish player, Cesar Ibizu, I think that's how you pronounce his name. Tim had some great skills, didn't he? Must have been a pleasure out there playing with him.
Yeah, it's pretty handy up front. I think he scored 10 goals in 8 games or something like that. So he was sort of our go-to man up front, inspired the younger guys. But unsure of what's going to be in store for next year. Maybe even try and keep things a bit more local, but we won't see.
Maybe a player that speaks English this time might help.
That might help a bit, because it's a bit hard trying to communicate with him in debriefs and matches, that's for sure.
All right, good stuff. Thanks for that, guys, and good luck for next season.
No worries.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you.